Today we are going to do the class 4, 5th standard, subject mathematics, and the topic is our first chapter, 5-digit numbers. So, till now, what and all we have discussed, this we will recall. So, in the first class, we have discussed about the numbers, right? The place values for the numbers, then greater number, smaller number, yes, then ascending, descending, then how to arrange the numbers and make a greatest number and smallest number. Do you remember what I am saying? If I give you 4-digit numbers, using this 4-digit number, you can arrange them to make greatest number and smallest number. So this also we have already discussed, right? So I have given you the homework also regarding this, and arranging in ascending and descending. What do you mean by the ascending? Small to big, and descending, big to small. Then we have also discussed about the smallest 5-digit number, least smallest 5-digit number. What is it? 10,000. Even we discussed how to put the comma with 5-digit. You have to leave from your right side 3-digit. 1, 2, 3, and you have to put comma. Right, children? And which is the greatest 5-digit number? This is the smallest. And the greatest 5-digit number is 99,999, right? So this is 99,999, the greatest 5-digit number. Even we discussed about writing the numbers to the given words. For example, if I write 1,000. 5. So what you used to do? You used to write in numbers. Right, children? So we used to write in numbers. That is 1,005. So if I give the digit, that is, what is this? How to read? 500. What you are going to read? The same you have to write. You have to learn the spellings also. Without spelling mistake, you have to write, children. Okay? That is 500. And even we discuss about how to get smallest next digit number. For example, if I give you 9, this is a single digit number. I want the smallest 2-digit number. How I used to get? I used to add plus 1. So 9 plus 1. So 9 plus 1 is 10. So 1-digit greater number is 9, and when it is added with plus 1, it gives you 10, which is smallest 2-digit number. Even about this, we discussed in our last class. Right, children? Even we discussed these things in our last class. Hope you have all understood whatever I have taught. In today's class, we are going to just recall whatever we have learned about place value chart. So, till now, we have learned many things about place value chart. What are other things are there in place value? That is ones. Yes, children? Let us start writing place value chart. So, up to 5-digit, you have to learn place value charts. Okay? Let me write now. Ones, it always starts with ones, tens, 100, Next thing, how to expand the numbers. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about expansion. Okay, expansion of numbers or expanding the numbers, both are same. So let me show you some example. Then you will remember. Already you have learned this in your fourth standard. Just you are recalling it. So this is 79. How to expand this? Expand. I am telling using your place value. 7 is in 10th place. 9 is in 1's place. So I can write 70 plus 9, right children? So I am going to divide 79 into 2, but 7 is in 10th place, so it became 70, and 9 is in 1 place, so 70 plus 9. Still further I want to expand. This is not sufficient for me. I want further to expand. How I am going to expand now? This 70 is in 10th form, right? So I can write this 70 as 7 into 10. That means 7 tens are 70. Yes, 9 is in 1's place. So 9 should be multiplied with 1. So now this is a further expansion of 79. So 70 into 10 plus 9 into 1. Let me give you one more number. 923. Expand now children. 9 is in 100 place. So it becomes 900. 2 is in 10th place. So it becomes 20. 3 is in 1's place. So 3 becomes 3. Now expand them further. I want to expand them further. Now I am going to expand. 9 is in 100th place. So 9 into 100 plus 2 is in 10th place. That is 2 into 10. Next, 3 is in 1's place. That is 3 into 1. Right, children? So I have expanded 923 as 900 plus 20 plus 3, because 9 is in 100th place, 2 is in 20 place, then 3. Then expand them further. So that is 9 into 100, 2 into 10 plus 3 into 1. So directly I want you to write the last expansion, second step of expansion for 1000th place. 5217, or we will take 19. 19 or 17, which are number we want? That number we can take. So now I want the second step of expansion. This is the first step of expansion. Second step of expansion. If anybody asks you to expand the numbers, you have to expand in this second method. Okay. So 5000. 5 is in 1000th place. So I have to write 5 into 1000 plus 2 is in 100th place. 2 into 100 plus 1 is in 10th place. So 1 into 10. Next, 9 is in 1's place. That is 9 into 1. Very good, children. Hope you have all understood this. So you want to 5-digit number now. Now we want 2-digit, 3-digit, 5-digit. If I give 0, what does it mean? How to expand when 0 is present? So I have given you 90,465. So I have given you 90,000. So first tell me the place value. 5 is in 1's place. 6 is in 10's place. 4 is in 100's place. And 0 comes under 1000 place. And 9 comes under 10,000 place. Right, children? Now let us expand this 90,465. So 90,000 becomes 9 into 9 is a 10,000 place. So 9 into 10,000 plus 0 into 1000 plus 4 into 100 plus 6 into 10 plus 5 into 1. So 5 into 1. So hope you have all understand these things. When 0 also comes, it does not change any place value. According to 0, where it comes, it should be multiplied with that place value. Even the 0 comes, it is in 1000 place, so it should be multiplied with 1000. So hope you have all understood about how to expand the numbers with first step and second step. But whenever if we ask, the teachers ask you how to expand the numbers, you have to use the second method using place values. Okay, this is the place value expansion. I hope you have all understood about this. The same thing they have given you in your textbook, page number 6 and 7, place value chart and expanded form of 5-digit numbers. I want you people to write both the example 1 and example 2 in your classwork. That means wherever you are writing your diary day homework. If I give homework, you are keeping one book and writing in that, right? The same book, you have to write these things also. Example 1, that is place value chart. Then example 2, this one, this table should also be written with the expansion of numbers. You have both expansion of numbers. Okay. Now let us see how does the abacus works with the expansion. So how does the abacus, have you heard of abacus, children? You had a class in the last 4th standard, right? You had abacus class, man used to come and teach you how to do the addition and subtraction using abacus instrument, right? The same thing in mathematics also, the abacus is there. So what does this abacus tells you? It has the sticks with the balls. So you have 5-digit, so I am writing 5-digit. With this we have a place value. That means first stick is 1, second stick 10, third stick 100, fourth stick 1000, fifth stick 10,000. So using this 5 sticks, we are going to do the abacus mathematics. Okay, let me give you one number. It's 85,921. So this is the number I have given you. I want you to use your bubbles and put in the place value stick. Let me see. The first ones, in ones place, what is there? Number 1. And how many ball I have to put in first stick? Only one ball. So I have to put only one ball in first string because in the ones place we have only number one. Come to the tenth place. In the tenth place, what is there? How many digits are there? Number two. So how many balls I have to put in tenth place? Two. So one, two. Right, children? How many balls I have to put? Two balls. Next, come to the hundredth place. How many balls are there in hundredth place? Yes, nine. Because in the hundredth place we have number nine, so the stick has to consist of nine balls. So the stick consists of nine balls. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So as we see the numbers and the place where you know that many balls you have to add to the stick. And the next number is 5. 5 is in 1000 place. So I have to come to 1000 place. In the stick, how many balls I have to put now? Yes, 5 balls. 1, 2, come with me. 3, 4, and 5. So how many balls I have added? 5 balls. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right, children? Next, last number, that is the fifth digit, that is number 8. Number 8 comes under which place? 10,000 place. So even in the abacus stick, I have to come to 10,000 place. And I have to mark, how many balls I have to mark? 8 balls. Come with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So how many balls I have added in the 10,000 place? 8 balls. Right, children? Let me give you one more number and you have to do by yourself. For example, 99,740. So I have given you one more number, that is 99,740. Right. So do it in the abacus now. The same place where you have to check it out. Let me rub these things and make a stick of it. Ones place, tens place, hundreds place, thousand place, 10,000 place. So in the ones place, what is the number? 0. So I have to add the ball or not? No, I should not add any balls because it says it's a 0. If nothing is there, means it is understood that the number is 0. And come to the tens place. What is the tens place? 4. Come to the abacus in the tens place. So how many balls I have to add now? Yes, 4 balls. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have to add one more upper itself. Yes, only 4. And come to the next digit, that is 7. 7 is in hundredth place. So how many balls I have to add? 7. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now come to the next place value, that is the 1000 place. 1000 place consists of number 9. So how many balls I have to add in 1000 place? 9 balls. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So how many balls I have added? 9 balls. Come to the 10,000 place. The 10,000 place is also number 9. And add 9 balls to 10,000 place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Hope you have understood how to write the balls in abacus method. Right, children? In this also we are values of 5-digit numbers. So hope today's lesson you have understood. So today we have discussed place value chart up to 5-digit. That means 10,000 place. So 1,000 group, unit group. Both we have understood. And even we learned about expanding of the numbers. So using the place value, today we expanded the number in first method and second method. The place value method is the correct method for expansion. That is the second method. And even we learned how to write in apparatus with the place value. Right? How to add the balls to the place values by using the given numbers. So I hope you have all understood what I have taught today. So I want you people to write today's assignment at page number 6 and 7 in your textbook. In page number 6, example 1 with the table and the expansion. Example 2 with the table and expansion. Again, example 1 with expansion with abacus. So what did we have learned today? The same thing I have given you to write in the book. Hope you have all understood what I have taught today. Have a great day, children. Bye-bye.